This is part 28 of Azure tutorial. In this video, we'll discuss how to auto swap deployment slots in Azure. If you're wondering why auto swap, well, auto swap allows us to deploy our app continuously with zero downtime. When auto swap is configured, for example, from staging to production deployment slot, every time we push code into staging slot, it is automatically swapped into the production slot without any manual intervention, and that too after it is warmed up in the source slot. This means you're able to deploy with zero downtime. How to configure auto swap? Well, it's straightforward. In the Azure portal, navigate to your app service. As you can see, I'm already on the app service page. Now let's navigate to deployment slots, and we do that by clicking on this deployment slots option under deployment. As you can see, we have three slots here: production, testing, and staging. We're going to configure auto swap from staging to production. So this means every time we push code into the staging slot, it'll be automatically swapped with the production slot. We'll see that in action in just a bit. If you're wondering, why do we need this testing slot? Well, here's the plan. We're going to make code modifications on our local development machine. Once we make those changes, we will push them to this testing slot, so we get the opportunity to test our changes in Azure, make sure everything is good. Once we are happy with the changes, we'll then push a build into the staging slot, which will be automatically swapped with the production slot. We'll see that in action in just a bit. So the first order of business here is to configure auto swap from staging to production. So our source slot for auto swap is staging and the target is production. So let's navigate to the source slot, in our case, staging. Click on configuration, which you can find under settings. And then click on general settings. Scroll a bit down. By default, as you can see, auto swap is turned off. We want to enable it. So select this on radio button. Remember, we want to auto swap from staging to production. So every time we push code into the staging slot, we want to swap it with production. So our source slot, as you can see here, is our staging slot, and our target is production. So select production from this drop-down list, and very important, don't forget to save changes. That's it. We have auto swap configured. Now, in the interest of time, here is what I have done in the background. I have deployed the same version of the app on all the three deployment slots, that is production, testing, and staging. So if we take a look at our testing URL, notice this is our testing URL. We can say that because in the URL, we have the word testing. All the five codes are displayed with a red background color. And the same is true even with our staging and production URLs. Notice here, we have our staging and production URLs side by side. On the left, we have our staging URL. Again, we can say that because we see the word staging in the URL. And on the right, we have our production URL. And these codes, again, are displayed with the same red background color for all codes. Now, what we want to do is display the alternate codes with a different color. And the change itself is pretty straightforward. It is the default page that displays these codes. And instead of using alert danger for both the item template and alternating item template, let's use a different color for alternating item template. And for that, all we have to use is a different Bootstrap class. Let's save our changes and push these changes to our testing deployment slot. So from this drop-down list, select the testing slot and then click publish. There we go. On our testing URL, we see alternate codes with a different background color as expected. So we are happy with our changes and we want to push these changes into our staging slot. So let's go back to Visual Studio, and from this drop-down list, let's select our staging slot and click publish. There we go. Deployment to the staging slot is complete. And for comparison, I have both the URLs side by side. Staging on the left and production on the right. And we have just pushed a code change into the staging slot, and we see the alternating codes with a different background color as expected. Remember, we configured auto swap from staging to production. So in a few seconds, these deployment slots should be automatically swapped. This means if we refresh these two pages, we should see the colors swapped. Let's do one by one. First staging and then production. There we go. The slots are swapped as expected. That's it in this video. Thank you for listening.